Hi and welcome to another session of business studies for the 12th standard with me Vishwanath sir, and we continue our journey with the case studies. And as I remind you time and often again that the case studies are a very important part of your CBSE questions for the business studies paper. So in order to know your case studies properly, it's relevant and very important that you understand the aspects of each of the chapters properly so that you're able to put this down into productive use. Okay, so I go to a chapter called organizing and I take up a few case studies on that basis. So the number one case study here, Alliance is engaged in manufacturing plastic buckets. The objective of the company is to manufacture 100 buckets a day. To achieve this, the efforts of all departments are coordinated and interlinked, and authority responsibility relationship is established between the various job positions. There is clarity on whom to report. Name the function of management discussed above. So when there is that responsibility and authority relationship, it is 100% organizing. So the function of management which is discussed in this case is organizing. I come to the next case study. To make the sports day of a school successful, the headmaster of the school divided all the activities into task groups, each dealing with a specific area of holding events, arrangement of medals, refreshment. Each group was placed under the overall supervision of a senior teacher. The physical education teacher was made responsible for holding the different events, the home science teacher for the refreshment and the maths teacher for the medals. Identify the function of management performed by the headmaster in doing so. Okay, so we are at this chapter, so 100% the function has to be organizing, because an event is going to come up, and when the event comes up, you have to be ready with all the different types of functions which will be held in the event. The next case study, Himalaya Limited is engaged in the manufacturing of washing machines. The target of organization is to manufacture 500 washing machines in a day. There is occupational specialization in the organization which promotes the efficiency of the employees. There is no duplication of efforts in such types of organization structure. Identify the organization structure which is described in this case. We can tell it is a functional structure because each one is performing their own functions. I come to the next case study from here. Piyush runs a factory where he manufactures leather shoes. The business is doing well and he intends to expand by diversifying into leather bags as well as leather jackets. Which type of organization structure would you recommend for his expanded organization and why? Give any two reasons. Okay, these two reasons can be those advantages. Yes, it's a functional structure because the company is first was producing a single product. Okay, it could be a lock. It could be locks for cars or other related products. Okay, and you once it is a functional structure, you have a dedicated approach and there is specialization in it. Okay, a company is manufacturing television, refrigerator, air conditioners, washing machines and gas stoves using different productive resources, and it is at the threshold of growth and requiring more employees. Suggest a suitable organization structure for this company, giving the reason in support of your answer. Okay, also put in the advantages and limitation, that is not a case study which you can put it on your own. So if you take this case up, I think the most suitable organization structure in this case would be a divisional structure. Since the company manufactures different products like television, refrigerator, air conditioners, washing machines and gas stoves, the company is on the threshold of growth and requires more employees. That means the organization will grow, and if it grows, it will add more employees and create more divisions and introduce new levels of management. Okay, so this is a plus point. When it grows, it will add more people. Okay, I go to the next one. Shreyas runs a lock manufacturing company. He wants to expand his business. For this, he wants to enter into the manufacturing of lock for cars for ancillary company. By doing this, his company will be able to provide many products to car manufacturers. Which type of organizational structure is this which he chooses for his factory and why? He chooses a functional structure because the company manufactures a single product, that is lock, or a number of related products like locks for cars. Okay, so this is the functional structure in this case. Mamta runs a factory where she manufactures shoes. The business has been doing well and she intends to expand by diversifying into leather bags as well as Western formal wear, thereby making her company a complete provider of corporate wear. This will enable her to market her business unit as one shop for working women. Which type of structure would you recommend for the expanded organization and why? We would tell this would be a divisional structure because it will produce multiple products like shoes, leather bags and Western formal. This means the organization will grow, it will add more employees and it will create more divisions and introduce new levels of management. So this is the divisional structure for you. From here onwards, we move to the next one. A company manufactures a popular brand of toys which has been enjoying the good market reputation. It has a functional organizational structure with separate departments for production, marketing, finance, human resource and research and development. Lately to use its brand name and also cash in the new business opportunity, it is thinking to diversify into a new range of electronic toys for which a new market is emerging. What type of organization structure would you recommend, giving some concrete reasons? I would basically recommend the functional structure instead of the divisional structure which it is now adopting. And when you are diversifying into a range of new products, you will see the divisional structure are created on the basis of different products in the enterprise. So they should, as far as possible, adapt the divisional structure. Earlier they were adapting the functional structure. Okay, I go to the next one. Bharat Limited is manufacturing medicines, soaps and computers. Which type of organizational structure would suit the requirements of such an organization? Divisional structure, better to put it under different divisions. The employees of Mehul Limited, a software company, has formed a dramatic group for their recreation. Name the type of organization. This is informal organization. Okay. From here, I go to the next one where I talk about Harsh, who started a company of Tiny Toys Limited to manufacture economical toys for the Indian rural market with 20 employees. The company did very well in the initial years. As the products were good and marketed well, the demand for the products went up. To increase the production, the company decided to recruit additional employees. Harsh, who was earlier taking all the decisions of the company, had selectively dispersed the authority. He believed that his subordinates are competent, capable and resourceful and can assume the responsibility for effective implementation of their decisions. This paid off and the company not only was able to increase its production but also expand its range with different features. So the first question here is, what is the concept which Harsh has been able to put forward whereby which his company has gone ahead? We can simply tell it is decentralization, because he didn't concentrate the power on one position, he distributed it to the others. Okay, I go to the next case study. A sales manager was assigned a target of selling 1,000 units in 1 month to 5 salesmen. One of the salesmen fell sick at the end of the month. Only 800 units could be sold. The sales manager feels that he is not responsible for this. Do you agree with this viewpoint? He has been a manager. He has to look after everything if someone doesn't fill in. No, you should... I truly disagree with this point. A manager can assign task or duty or delegate his work to the subordinates. He can, however, he cannot turn a blind eye to how the tasks are performed and how the delegated authority is exercised. The manager is accountable. Okay, he should have told that each one could have increased it by 50 units and made it 250 instead of 200 units. So this is his fault, or he could have appointed someone on a part-time basis. Okay, so he is at fault and it is not correct on his part to tell that he is not responsible. Otherwise, he shouldn't be holding that particular position. A company manufacturing sewing machines set up in 1944 follows the formal organization structure. It is facing a lot of problems, such as delay in decision making. As a result, it is not able to adapt to the changing business environment. The workforce is also not motivated and there is a problem of red tapeism and the employee turnover is high. So the first question which comes here, advise the company to change bringing about the organization structure to overcome the problem it is facing. The company should give due importance to the informal organization also. Why? This increases the job satisfaction. The people will feel that they are their own. They can contact anyone whom they want and they can have friendly relation. Informal groups can also provide useful communication channels which may help to transmit the information easily. Okay, so this is where they should be taking advantage of the informal organization. Okay. We talk about a company which manufactures consumer goods and it has grown in size. It was a market leader, but with the change of economic environment and with the entry of multinational corporations, its market is declining. The company was following a centralized business model and even the minor decisions were in the hands of the top level. Before 1991, this model was suitable for the company, but now the company is under the pressure to reform. What are the changes which the company brings about in order to retain its market share? Okay, so what happens is that now they have to make sure that it must share its information with the middle level management and even the bottom level management. They should introduce the concept of decentralization, because in this scenario, the business environment will change and you have to adapt to that change. If you can adapt to that change, then you will come out to be a winner. Okay. The directors of a company found that managing the divisional structure is becoming difficult, though they have a strong management team and workforce. They want a good grip over the organization. What should they do? So, it appears difficult to deal with the production and marketing of different products being produced at different places. The management can analyze and find out the products are profitable. The production of the remaining products can be discontinued. The divisional structure may be converted into a functional one. So remember, the divisional structure can be converted into a functional one and more emphasis can be laid on the products which are profitable. So this is a better grip on the functional, maybe had on the functional structure. Okay. In an electrical goods manufacturing company, there are four main activities: marketing, production, finance and personnel. The general manager is planning the structure, who is planning to structure the organization. Which type of organization structure should he adopt? Very simple, he should adopt the functional structure. This and much more, kindly go through the case studies, understand it, put it into constructive use. Thank you so much. This is Vishwanath sir, signing off.